Jason was, I guess, this really screaming, ugly, irritable little bastard lying in a pram, looking up at his father and unable to speak because he still hadn't found the word for dad, saying, I want, in his own language. And he's never continued to, he's always continued to do that from that day onwards. He's a good lad, and he was a good lad all the way through, but he was always very boisterous and, I guess, not demanding, but if you went around to see his dad, you'd have to see him too. Bonzo had a games room, which you can see in the song remains the same, and with a snooker table. And a big jukebox with all music from every era. Jason's kit was set up by the side of it. We used to come back from wherever we'd been together and all sit down and mess around and start dancing about. Jukebox would be real loud, and Jason would get on his little kit, poor little tot, and he'd have to play all this stuff, you know? I mean, he was the better than the drummer with Stevie Dan, better than the Temptations drummer, better than Bonzo, better than everybody, because he was sober.
And I used to come downstairs and I said, can he put the jukebox in and play to music, you know? But once you go back to bed now. No way, mate! I'm playing away. I can't go on all night.
Yeah, he's a good drummer. He always was a good drummer. He was good in those days, but he learnt from the records. And he just had that flair to do it. You know, he may not have got all the fills right, but he certainly had the attitude. And you could see that when he was, I don't know, 4 or 5.
I guess the great thing that John taught him more than anything else was to be sparing in the way that he played. I mean, the fact that Bonzo was and is as yet the greatest exponent of true drumming in the rock and roll idiom, passing that treaty on to his son was the most important thing, really. To be sparing, let everybody else go mad.
There was one amusing story, really, where when we were playing Nebworth, which was actually our last British gig.
Right.
And we were doing a sound check and doing Trampled Underfoot. And we were playing along, concentrating on the guitar, and I looked round and Jason was on the drums.
You're kidding.
Yeah. It was so John could go out the front and listen to his, you know, sound balance.
But then we got the complaints from the police because the drums could be heard, I think, 7.5 miles away in the next town. And it was Jason, but you couldn't tell. I mean, Paige didn't know that it wasn't.
Well, he was playing guitar, was he?
Mm. So he didn't know. Bonzo just let him play, and Paige turned around and saw. Oh.
He certainly got the sort of power within his drumming, which is, I mean, it's just right for me, you know.
Well, there's certain aspects of his demeanour which are similar. I mean, he's from the same blood, you know. But he plays great. He's improving all the time, which is what I knew he would do.
Obviously, the influence of my father is there from the one he taught me at a very early age. But I suppose he hasn't been around there for 8 years, so I've seemed to, you know, not progressed in a way, but I've created my own type of style with him. Obviously, he's the backbone to me.
1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
It was quite weird. Jimmy rang me up and said, "These things, I don't know if it's going to happen, but it could be a Led Zeppelin reunion." And I went, "Oh dear, my dream has come true. I'm going to play drums in Led Zeppelin." Oh no, you know, it's one of those things. It was amazing. And I sat in my, this is so funny, I sat in my front room, my family, at a drum store, set my drum kit up in my front room, my little house in England where I live. And I played every Led Zeppelin album and played for five to six days playing every album because I wasn't too sure what they were going to do. And I wanted to get up on it.
And here we are. Interview with John Muldoon. Take one.
I'm really pissed off, mate.
Fingers very sore.
Fingers.
2, 2, 2.
We actually had one rehearsal in England, which people probably don't know. I'll say this because it's true, we did have one rehearsal in England, but we did go over about 15 to 20 songs. And we just couldn't decide because Robert hadn't decided on what he wanted to do. So we finally get to New York. We're all jet lagged, and we go down to the studio, try the equipment out. We think, great, it's gonna be fine. So then the next day we all turn up. We start playing. Robert turns up. It was absolutely amazing.
For the Atlantic reunion. That's the first time I really ever played with Jason. But he really knows all the stuff very, very well. But we're playing away in some number, and I just naturally, you sort of slot back, you know, things get remembered, and I just went into a very old fill that I used to do, and he's right there with me. And it's one of those things that bass players and drummers only do when they've been married for 10 years, right? And we went straight into it, and I just looked round, and he went, Chicago, 1975.
Come true, you know. I mean, my first dream obviously was from a very young age to play with Led Zeppelin, and I've done that, and believe you me, that was the most emotional, stressful thing in my life to do. It was just so wonderful to play with Led Zeppelin, to be up there at Madison Square Gardens when the curtain rises, and Jimmy turned to me and went, count it in, and it was like, wow. 2, 3, 4, Cashmere. Da-da-da. Cashmere, it says it all, and to open up with Cashmere at Madison Square Gardens for me was just one, the most amazing time of my life, and two, the most frightening time of my life, because my heart was here. I was frightened, but because they'd done it before, you know, they've done it before, they didn't have to prove a thing, but for me to go on there and not play good, you know, it could have been the end of my career, really. If the truth was to be known, it could have been the end of my career, because everyone had gone, he could never do it. But I went out there, and hopefully, from what people told me, and I believe myself, I did it, you know. I proved to the world that I can actually play drums.